No. Collecting.
Isn't it too busy in the morning?
Can't be too busy.
Collecting?
Aye. What are you collecting, a Thursday and a
Friday and a Saturday and a
Friday,
Sunday?
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Is it ever?
Sunday's a big day.
Is it?
Aye.
I guess all the rest of them is still
right. Right, we'll see you.
When?
A week come Sunday.
What about the morning?
No.
Not
No. I'll all be in the morning.
Okay.
I'll be born at the Brough Farm.
Here's the Brough Farm.
Brough Farm, you means.
And how did you get into...
And I was born in 1910. And I started to deliver malt in 1920 with my father down at Humanes. That's the time that the tram cars were running. And then for that, my father died in about 1923.
So he's always been involved?
Huh?
You always been involved?
Aye.
In milk all the time?
My mother, she bought a dairy shop in Glasgow, and I came up to Shots. Come up to 91 Benhar Road. I've been there ever since. Away back in the 1920s, there used to be about 20 milkmen in Shots. All the farmers come out and sold their own malt. But each one was selling about 10, 16, 20 gallon a day. And the time goes on, this one dropped off, another one dropped off. And comes a time that it all dropped off. So that only left frame just to struggle with his cell.
So how many milkmen are there now in Shots?
And at the present time, there are only 3 milkmen.
I see there a picture here, picture of the Galladay. You actually used to supply the horse and the carriage.
Well, it was a pageant day and I was driving the coach. The coach belonged to me right enough. I was driving it and always picked out the girl, the top class in the school.
This is you, the driver here?
Aye.
That was a few years ago right now.
And they picked out the top girl in the class at the school and she was crowned at the school. And we're hurling around all the streets in Shots. And well, we made it a good day.
That's good. I hope it wasn't raining, you know, it usually rains in...
Huh?
Usually rains in Shots, Galladay.
No, well... Mm-hmm. Only the first time, the 1938, was an awful bad day. But after that, it was quite good.
Who's this?
And these are the milk boys I had. The chap frame... Worked with me for a long time. In fact, I got married there last week. Another one was Denny, and he's still working away yet with me.
And is that just an odd picture?
That's the same two.
The same two again.
It's a woman that come from Canada. She wanted to see some of her friends in Shots. So I took her around in the van and I let her see all our friends. And a man, he took the 40 and he took it home to Canada and sent me a 40.
Good, that's nice.
Ah, well, we had a lot of big runs: Whitburn, Barkett, Armadale, West Calder, Mid Calder, Paul Bear, and Hamilton, and I sold them all. And I've just left the Shops now. And the Shots people are very good to me.
Why did you sell?
Huh?
Why did you sell all your runs?
Well, I had to flip it over there from the business, but I wouldn't want to flip out the Shots. And that's how it went.
Shots is the place for you.
Aye.
Uh-huh. What was this you were saying about the?
Huh?
You were saying the police actually stopped you or booked you for speeding or tell us about that.
Well, that time, like,
aye, what happened?
Well,
then?
They stopped me anyway, and and it was in the papers in another week or two saying I was the fastest milkman in the West. They stopped me telling me I was going too slow.
Going too slow? Did you get fined for that?
No.
No?
And they put it in the papers, I was the fastest milkman in the West.
So how long have you actually been delivering milk for?
What, delivering milk?
Aye, how many years?
65 years.
65 years?
And I started in 1920, and I'm still on the road every morning. I rise at 3:30 in the morning. We start delivering it at 4 o'clock.
Uh-huh. And is it quite a big run you've got? Does it take you many hours to deliver your milk?
Huh?
Does it take you a long time to deliver your milk?
Well, we start at 4 and we finish at 8:30.
So it's quite a large run you've got.
That's about 1,400 pints.
Is that a day or a week?
1,400 pint delivered at the doors every morning.
You tell us what time in the morning you get up to deliver your milk?
Well, at the present time, I got up at 3:30. I phoned my laddie, Tom, and Tom come down about 4 o'clock. He loads the van and we start delivering it. We start delivering it to the doorstep for about 4:15 to about 8:30. And we come in and we load the van about to 9 o'clock and we go round all the shops. And Tom finished about 11 o'clock. And but I take over. And I go round the shop from about 12 to about 1:30. I get him a weed up to extra milk. And that for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And Thursday, we'll go out about 3:30 and collect the money to about 4 o'clock, to about to 7 o'clock. And on Friday, we start at 11 o'clock and we collect the money to about 9 o'clock at night. And on Saturday, we start collecting money for about 12 o'clock to about 5 o'clock. And on Sunday, we collect the money for about 12:30 to about 4:30. That just collecting money only. The gala day, we used to have all the fancy dress parades. We used to have the bands all done up. We used to get first prize. And for about 1934 to about 1938, we used to show the horses at Whitburn, Basket and Armadale, in West Calder. And we used to get the first prize for the best turnout. First prize for the riding horse.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you used to deliver milk with the horse and cart?
Yeah. Well, years ago you just had the horse and cart, and that's how you had. Uh-huh. And you had the milk just in a big barrel. And you measured it and tipped it into the women's jugs.
But was the jugs lying outside?
Well, the jugs at the doorstep. Uh-huh. So years ago, they hadn't any bottles. Uh-huh. Just the cans.
So did you not get bothered with, like, dogs and cats?
Huh?
Did you not get bothered with dogs and cats?
No.
No? Maybe you stealing the milk?
Oh, well, I put it all with a lid and it came with a saucer. On the top of their jugs. Uh-huh. No, maybe about a month or 2 months.
In the year?
And for the 65 years.
In 65 years you've only been off 2 months? Do you never go any holidays?
Well, the last holiday I had, it was in 1938.
Do you not get fed up delivering milk all the time?
No, no, I'm quite happy. I went to Ailey in 1928 to give my hand for to clip the sheet.
And that was a holiday?
That was a holiday. And we're down in the Isle, the hen in the coal in the Isle, just peat, kind of peat fires. And all your meat, your dinner and tea was all kind of peat reeking. But, well, you got kind of used to it, but the first time it was terrible. But you got quite kind of used to it, Ken.
So I think you're maybe due a holiday sometime anyway.
And I never had a drink in my life. I never smoked a cigarette in my life.
That's how you're so healthy, you know, and you...
I would take a pint of milk every day. That keeps me going.
I thought you'd maybe be sick of milk.
No.
Know, because you deliver it all the time.
No.
You wouldn't actually drink it. So how many people actually works for you at the present?
Well, and when I had a big run, I had about... There's 75 kind of working for me. But to now, well, we just do shots in Arlington and Hartwood and Springhill.
And how many vans do you have?
When?
How many vans do you have?
When the now?
Aye, the now.
Oh, no, no. Well, I've just got the two now.
Just the two vans?
But I used to have about 14 or 16.
When was that?
About 42 years ago.
A long time ago. Right. You used to bottle your own milk.
Oh, aye.
So you had a dairy.
Aye. Oh, aye. We had a dairy and we bottled our own milk. About 22 years ago. About 22 about a year ago, we're doing a myth about 2,000 gallon a day.
Is that selling it to other people? Other milkmen?
Hmm?
Was that you selling your milk to other people too?
No, not for one run.
For your own run?
That we're doing Whitburn, Bark and all these places.
Right. And do you not do that anymore?
No, I sold it all. Oh. This is Dave Bangor and... Tippett Hill.
No, do you not actually bottle your milk at your dairy anymore?
No.
Why is that?
Well, I just kind of buy it in now and kind of cut down expenses.
Tell me you were a bit of a dancer when you were younger too, you were.
Hmm?
Tell me you liked the dancing when you were younger.
Well, in my young days, I used to go around dancing all, kind of just a farmer ball. Uh-huh. Go to Whitburn, West Calder.
They very popular then?
Mid Calder, Bigger, Straven, Hamilton, Airdrie, kind of just a farmer ball.
How would you actually get there? Would you actually...
Oh, well, over the car.
With a car there. Mm-hmm.
I was the MC for about 20 years. The farmer ball started in this chapel. And our part, it was transferred into Calderhead School. And after the building of Masonic Hall, the farmer ball went into Masonic Hall, and they built the welfare hall. We shipped it into the welfare hall, and I run it for 20 years. When I stopped running it, the dance stopped it.
Stopped?
And we used to hear them all coming from Whitburn, Barkett, Armadale, Kaloot, Lanark, Bigger, all round to the short farmer's ball. Uh-huh. Because they've got good service, good band, and it'd be the best in the town.
story about a girl who came my way. We helped her marry, three kids, a dog in Santa Fe. Sentimental institution. I'm gonna pack all my little old blues away. But I didn't stay, left on the shelf. Mrs. Johnson from Wisconsin, she's a widow. Minnesota from Dakota likes the way I make a tea.
Sweet as candy.
I'm gonna join the sentimental institution. No one to stop me from playing better coming on.
Just step my way. The band starts to play.
I can thrill her with Glenn Miller or a song from
Louisiana
with Jim Dorsey or Artie Shorey. Though this magic can't go wrong. Old and lovely, she's so wealthy.
Do 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 do